now is the extent of infection in countries. And some of this comes from the surveillance, which is detected through the PCR testing. But there's an additional tool that we have, which is gathering information about the extent of infection through seroepidemiology, which is measuring the extent of infection in people who may have been missed through surveillance, and we detect the antibody levels in those individuals. And while I don't have specific details about Azerbaijan, we are learning from a number of countries that early results suggest that a large proportion of the population remains susceptible. And that's an important feature, because that means that there still are people that this virus can infect. And so in addition to how we intensify the measures to increase, you know, the so-called lockdown measures, as well as lifting those in a controlled and studied way, it's really important that we remain vigilant, that we remain vigilant to identify cases very, very quickly through all of the systems that we have been describing. And that early action, again, even if countries have been successful in suppressing transmission, it's important that they remain vigilant to be able to detect those quickly and stamp it out right away. So these seroepidemiology studies have been very important, even though they're early, even though there are some limitations with these studies that have come out so far. It's important that we understand at this point in time, 4 months into a global pandemic, a large proportion of the population still remains susceptible.
Thank you very much. So this was answer to Cameron.